The Ruse Sports Network presents Kansas City Ruse Women's Basketball. A big one today near the top of the Western Athletic Conference standings as the Ruse welcome in the preseason league favorites, the New Mexico State Aggies, for the first of two scheduled meetings between these clubs this season. New Mexico State 2-0 in league play. Kansas City is 2-1. Nice and toasty here inside the Swinney Center today for a game delayed one day by weather. I'm Stephen Davis. Great to have you with us today. Bad weather, poor travel conditions yesterday here in the Kansas City area, necessitating the postponement of this game to high noon today for what should be a great showdown between two of the top programs in the WAC. The Ruse come into this ballgame off a win Thursday night over UTRGV, a big win and a big come-from-behind win as Kansas City erased a 14-point halftime deficit in that ballgame. 6'5 center Christina Soriano, a big reason why she had her fourth straight double-double in the ballgame. 14 points and 11 rebounds. Erica Mattingly got going in the second half. She would finish the ballgame with 17 points as the Ruse chipped away, got that deficit down, and eventually overtook UTRGV and for good in the final couple minutes of the ballgame. A big reason why was the play of sophomore guard Jonae Johnson. She's been playing extremely well of late. She started the last eight ballgames. She finished Thursday night with 12 points, including the go-ahead and eventual game-winning basket with about 90 seconds to go. Johnson scoring 12 points the other night. She and the Ruse are unbeaten this season when she scores at least 10. Ruse will look to make it two in a row today as they take on New Mexico State. Tip-off from Kansas City comes your way next on the Ruse Sports Network.
They love. Give them Highland, healthy and wholesome, fresh from your hometown dairy.
Represents some of the best and brightest minds in Kansas City.
And then here's my roommate.
Gotta learn how to be tough.
Your mission is to leave from this place and go out on purpose and make a better world.
Here's my 3, 1, 2, 3.
Inside the Swinney Center, New Mexico State and Kansas City today. First meeting of two in the regular season this year. These two teams met three times a year ago. Brooke Atkinson, SWAC champions, won all three times last year. Two third-year head coaches today. Brooke Atkinson at a program that has won five consecutive WAC regular season titles. Last year, a 17-game winning streak, and they went 26-7 overall. Starting lineups today are brought to you by Coca-Cola for the Aggies. Sophia Inusa, freshman from Sweden. Didi Eccles, Nana Sule, Amanda Soderquist, and Gia Pack, who along with the Ruse, Erica Mattingly, split the preseason league player of the year voting. Mattingly in there for the Ruse, along with Johnson in the backcourt. And then a Jack, Foster Walker, and Soriano up front for Kansas City coach J.C. Hoyt, coming off a winning record a season ago, but that season ended at the hands of New Mexico State in overtime in the conference tournament semifinals. Ruse are in the gold, New Mexico State in the maroon. Ball in the air, and we are underway with Kansas City winning the tap. Mattingly gets it in the hands of Johnson, and the Ruse get into their half-court offense against man-to-man defense for the Aggies. Mattingly going backdoor to a jack. Trying to get one up under the hoop, blocked, but able to save it out to Johnson. Shot clock did not reset. Foster Walker, a fadeaway. And into the hands of Pack on the rebound. Keys to the game brought to you by Movement Mortgage. Ruse will want to keep Christina Soriano involved inside early and often. Four straight double-doubles for Soriano coming in. And then the Battle of the Stars. Gia Pack was the preseason league player of the year as voted by the league coaches. Mattingly was the preseason league player of the year selection for the league's media. This is Pack firing one inside. Picked off, though, by Mattingly. They both put up huge numbers in the three meetings a season ago, especially in that conference tournament overtime ball game as a jack took an extra step and walked with it. Both Mattingly and Pack scored their career high in that conference tournament matchup a year ago. Mattingly dropping 37 to go along with 10 rebounds and 4 assists in the loss. Pack went for 36 with 5 assists and 3 steals. Will those kind of numbers be needed today from the two stars? Pack is a 5'10 junior out of Phoenix. She's teamed with Brooke Salas the last couple years to make New Mexico State head and shoulders above the rest of the league. Aggies trying to win a 6th straight WAC title. Shot clock's down to 1. That ball knocked away. It's a shot clock violation. And well, the offense is on both ends not having any success right now. This is a defensive struggle in the opening 4 possessions. Ruse do lead the league in defensive field goal percentage, holding opponents to 37.5% shooting. Mattingly wide open out front. Soriano kept it alive. Pack comes away with it and races it the other way. She is so versatile. Handle the ball, does everything, and here sets up Soderquist, 3-point specialist from Sweden, for the first points of the game. Soderquist with her 28th three-pointer of the year. She is the 7th best three-point shooter in the league, both in percentage and makes this season. Johnson attacking right side, stops on a dime and banks it home. Jonae Johnson gets the Ruse on the board. Johnson scored a total of 1 point in 3 matchups with New Mexico State last season. Little zone look from the Ruse. This is Dee Eccles up top, dribbled it off her foot. Foster Walker comes away with it. Eccles wearing number 21 today for New Mexico State. She normally wears number 15. Skip pass for Johnson, looking in at Soriano over the top. Christina draws an immediate double team and throws it away. Soriano has been a very good passer this season, but off target there, trying to get it away from the two defenders. J.C. Hoyt making an early substitution. Emily Ivory, the Ruse best three-point shooter, is into the ballgame. A jack has gone out. Momentary break in the action is Nana Sule, 6-foot junior for New Mexico State, adjusted her knee brace on her left knee. Multiple Aggies wearing braces on their left knees. Sule all strapped up again and ready to go. She's the inside presence in the starting lineup for the Aggies. Eccles spinning it right side to Pack. Shot clock's down to 6. Running the baseline and firing and hitting is Soderquist. 2 early triples for Soderquist, matching her point total from their win Thursday in Chicago over Chicago State, 73-60. Ivory launching to try to match. In and out. Soriano the rebound. fouled as she took it back up with the left hand. Three-point shooting will be key in this one. The Aggies don't rely on the three ball. They make only 4.3 triples a game. The Roos, on the other hand, are the second most proficient three-point shooting team in the league in terms of makes, just under 7 a game. Kansas City counts on the three balls. It's Soriano's numbers for the season. They've been going up, up, and up of late. Ivory with the easy rebound. Pack did not block her out. Roos get another chance to add points. Soriano went 1 of 2 at the line. Jada Mickens is in, finding Soriano in the cut and drawing another foul. Whistle goes against Soderquist. Soriano active. 75% free throw shooter for the season. Soriano last season shot under 50% at the line. Under today, ranked 7th in the league in free throw shooting. Three early points for Christina, and the Roos are within one. Backcourt pressure from Kansas City. Adriana Henderson handles in the backcourt. Soderquist spins it ahead. Aaliyah Prince attacks. Soriano says no. Aggies keep it. Soriano so different this season as a basketball player and playing with so much confidence as well. Prince pull up from the free throw line. Was that partially blocked? It was. Aaliyah Prince got off to a hot scoring start to the season. 3 straight 20-plus point games. 8 straight in double figures, but has been in double digits only twice in the last 6 games. Did have 12 on Thursday at Chicago State. She can be instant offense. This is Henderson going to work. High arcing banker doesn't go off the glass. Mattingly in a big hurry the other way. Ivory, the open look on the wing. Got it! Emily Ivory had been just 1 of 13 in conference play on three balls. Gets an early one today. Mattingly with the foul there in the press. First on Erica. If Emily Ivory gets hot, it really changes this Roo offense. The 3 games last year against New Mexico State, Ivory got lots of looks. A combined 32 three-point attempts in those 3 games. But she made just 6. Mattingly the deflection. Quick high five from her head coach. Roos are active in this zone. Even aggressive at times, you might say. Kayla Buckner in the middle of the zone around Soriano, but can't finish. Johnson on the pull-up. Hits. Jonae Johnson with the strong mid-range game, and the Aggies take an early timeout. Not quite halfway through quarter number one. The Roos are on an 8-0 run. Kansas City by 4 on the Roos Sports Network.
Foods they love. Give them Highland, healthy and wholesome, fresh from your hometown dairy.
This room represents some of the best and brightest minds in Kansas City.
And then here's my roommate.
Gotta learn how gotta be tough.
Your mission is to leave from this place and go out on purpose and make a better world.
3-1-3, 1-2-3.
The Ruse Sports Network is brought to you by Niles Media, a division of LTN, and by Truman Medical Center and University Health, the official health care of Kansas City Athletics. Eight-0 run for the Ruse, leading it 10-6. Backcourt pressure from Kansas City. Aggies get it across. Soderquist has all their points, a pair of threes. A pack yet to really get a look. Eccles is back in. Her three ball is on target. This Aggie team that doesn't depend on the three-point shot has three here in the opening quarter. Three of three from deep. Mattingly spinning it right side for Ivory. Soriano wants it. Wilkins late on the delivery, turns it over. Aggies nearly give it right back. Pack pushing the other way up ahead for Prince for the easy finish. A quick five from the Aggies have them back on top. Three assists already for Pack. Immediately turn that Rue turnover into 2 points at the other end. Three turnovers each way in this one. Mattingly using the ball screen. Sets up Ivory. In and out that time. Emily getting good open looks though. Had three shots on the way already. Prince gets the runner to go from the elbow. Back-to-back buckets in transition for Aaliyah Prince. And the Aggies have answered the Ruse eight straight with seven in a row. Mattingly, plenty of space behind the ball screen, but off target. Rebound tapped around. The tie-up. Arrow will keep it with the Aggies. Aggies have gone eight deep on the bench already, eight total players. Ruse have played seven so far. First quarter is brought to you by the Truman Medical Center. Sticking with that zone look. Caleb Buckner, a turnaround is good right in the center of the zone. 6'4 grad transfer from North Texas. Makes it a 9-0 New Mexico State run. Yankees have hit four of their last five shots. They have not scored in more than 2 minutes, and that streak will continue. An illegal screen called against Soriano. Pack fires it up ahead. Prince, trouble making the catch. Finds the handle. And he's getting organized. Inside the zone, they don't get it to her. Eccles over the zone, off target. They'll jack the rebound. Ruse have hit just one of five from downtown so far. Shot a moment ago was the Aggies' first miss in four tries out there. Three minutes without points for the Ruse. Mattingly crossing over, pull up 17-footer. Soriano gets on the glass. Put back, no, another try, no, but a foul. Soriano having her way inside, getting rebounds.
Kansas City.
Foul going on Echols. Sending Soriano to the line for the third time already today. All of Soriano's points coming from the stripe. 4 out of 5 so far. Hits them both. That ends the scoring drought for Kansas City. Not slowed the Aggie offense, though, the last few possessions. Get him into a half-court set this time. Henderson. Now Prince. Ball screen. Threw it into a crowd. Foul on Kansas City. It's against a Jack. Prince jumped to make a pass. And Anike Adorinto was not expecting it. Not even turned around to try to find the basketball. The pass was already in the air. And he's fortunate to hit that foul call. Three fouls each way with 90 seconds to go in the quarter. Pack will fire from the wing and hit. 4 threes in the first quarter for New Mexico State. Right about what they average per game. But Jack to answer and does. The wall of Jack's 30th triple of the year. Turned into a horse contest here at Swinney. Long term, that would favor the Rouge, you figure. Mexico State's been the better shooting team this opening quarter. Now a 3-second call on Adorinto. Rouge have beaten New Mexico State only 3 times in history in 17 matchups. Way short on that three was a Jack. Only win in WAC play for the Rouge against New Mexico State was in February of 2014. Hand check foul called against Johnson. Mexico State will have it on the side. Back waiting to get it in, finally does. Nearly a 5 count. Out to the wing to get it. The pack's so dangerous wherever she touches the ball. A traveling call against Echols. Bruce can hold for the final shot of the quarter if they want. Bring Emily Ivory back in. Be guarded by Pack. Mattingly watching the clock. Soriano hands it back to her. Mattingly left hand being fouled by Adorinto. They got a favorable matchup, did the Ruse on the switch there on the handoff. Adorinto taking Mattingly. Erica took it hard to the basket. 2 free throws for the 71% free throw shooter. Averaging 16 points per game, third most in the league. Fourth in assists. Mattingly on the scoreboard. 6.7 seconds left. We'll try to hurry it up the floor, does to Soderquist. Inside, all alone, Adorinto missed it. And that does it for quarter number one. Cruz catching a break there. New Mexico State had a point blank shot. High energy up and down first quarter. And a 2-point game, 10 minutes in on the Rouge Sports Network.
them the dairy foods they love. Give them Highland, healthy and wholesome, fresh from your hometown dairy.
This room represents some of the best and brightest minds in Kansas City.
And then here's my roommate.
Gotta learn how to be tough.
Your mission is to leave from this place and go out on purpose and make a better world.
The Ruse Sports Network is brought to you by Coca-Cola, by Minsky's, and by Adidas. In some respects, amazing. It's a two-point game as we start the second quarter. Kansas City shooting just 4 of 13 in the first. Mexico State was 7 of 14, including 4 of 5 from downtown. Ivory, floater from the foul line, barely got to the rim. Ruse did get to the line 8 times and make 6 of them in that first quarter. The Aggies' hot shooting continue against this Ruse zone. Henderson on the drive, had it knocked away and stolen. Mickens has it. No numbers. Gets it to a trailing Johnson. Mattingly is out right now for Kansas City. Down at the end of the bench being worked on by the athletic trainers and doctors. Foster Walker in the lane, gets the bounce. The freshman, Tasia Foster Walker, who was shut out in the win Thursday against UTRGV, ties it with that basket. Foster Walker did have 9 rebounds in the win on Thursday. See Mattingly at the end of the bench being tended to. They're working on something in her head. Traveling call. Musa with the extra step. The time Erica Mattingly has to spend on the bench in a game like this is too long for Kansas City. Pulling back on the three. Playing very perimeter-based offense right now. Try to get it into Foster Walker, knocked away. It'll stay with Kansas City. Shot clock's at just 7, though. Mickens, tough catch in traffic. Ivory gets the open look. Maybe rushed it just a bit. Deflected rebound to a Jack. Can't score it under the hoop. Foster Walker keeping it alive. Still loose. The Aggies have it. Back on the run. Lost the handle. Henderson well short. Mickens keeps it in. A frenetic action right now. Shots coming at a rapid pace, but not close to their targets. 2 points so far this quarter. Rue basket from Foster Walker. Ruse have scored the last 6 going back to the first. Johnson has it poked away by Pack, loose on the floor. Mickens dives and they'll tie it up. Arrow to New Mexico State. Ruse have not scored for the last minute 40. Mexico State on a scoreless drought that will be at 4 minutes very shortly. And they'll extend even longer. Lackadaisical catch by Prince cost some possession. Eight Aggie turnovers, as you see Mattingly. And that ponytail fixed. She'll be back in the game shortly. That wound on her head cleaned up. Into Soriano back in the game, finding Mickens on the cut, and fouled by Eccles. Two now on Eccles. Mexico State, just a 5-10 record this year, not up to their usual standard. There is a year that you would consider the WAC open in women's basketball. This might be it. Mattingly's coming back in for the Ruse. Here's where we think she got hit on the head, yeah. Erica clutching the right side of her head. That headband may be shielding it just a bit so it wasn't noticed initially. No headband now, the senior star. Meanwhile, Jada Mickens knocks down a pair of free throws. It's an 8-0 Kangaroo run and a 2-point lead. Mexico State scoreless for nearly 4.5 minutes. Turn around at the free throw line, banks in for Michaela Buckner. That ends the long Aggie drought. Buckner's second basket. Johnson working hard against Prince. Aggressive defense on the perimeter from the Aggies. Soriano back door to Mickens. Block, Jada to the floor to keep it alive, and a tie-up. We'll keep it with Kansas City. Just six on the shot clock, though. Mattingly will have to hurry. How about a 28-footer? Almost banked it in. Johnson keeps the possession, though, with the offensive rebound. Good hustle from Jone. The sophomore from Chicago will go to work. Elbow pull-up. Just everything. Both defenses so active and aggressive. Even open shots are getting short on. Just as though they're surprised to have an open look. Buckner finding Prince. And Taylen Gray's in the game for the first time. Off target on a 12-footer. Both teams continue to struggle shooting. Mattingly fearlessly attacking. Ivory open on the wing. Strong. Emily's one of five from downtown. Soderquist hit a couple early. Not this time. Rebound knocked out. Rue ball. Four to two is the score here in the second quarter. Kansas City shooting one of eight. New Mexico State one of five. Told Mattingly took a tooth to the head, causing that wound that required attention. Soriano, nice patience, left-hand finish. Beautifully done inside by the 6'5 senior. 7 points, five rebounds for Soriano in this first half. On pace for what would be a fifth straight double-double. Pack from downtown, short. Rue ball. We get a timeout. 4:53 to go, first half. Advantage Kansas City by two over New Mexico State on the Rouge Sports Network.
dairy foods they love. Give them Highland, healthy and wholesome. Fresh from your hometown dairy.
This room represents some of the best and brightest minds in Kansas City.
And then here's my roommate.
Gotta learn how to be tough.
Your mission is to leave from this place and go out on purpose and make a better world.
...27% shooting for the Ruse, but they are on top by two. Over New Mexico State, Stephen Davis with you at the Swinney Center in Kansas City. Most of this city's attention focused on pro football franchise Chiefs, hosting a divisional round playoff game in about 90 minutes. Big one here in women's basketball today, though, in the WAC. Ruse 2-1 in league play, New Mexico State 2-0. Utah Valley, Cal State Bakersfield also unbeaten in conference play. Utah Valley's already beaten the Ruse. Steal by Henderson to the other end against Johnson. Lost the handle as Johnson was able to get a piece of it and knock it free. Utah Valley 3-0 in the league. Bakersfield 2-0. Utah Valley beat Seattle U yesterday 70-58. Doesn't go for Buckner. Henderson stuffed by Soriano. Send it back, Christina. What an emphatic rejection. Back. Finding Prince in the back door. Elevation for Aaliyah Prince getting the bounce. At 22. Third tie. We've had three lead changes. Jack will launch and hit. A wall of Jack connects on her second three today. Prince over the top. With the long rebound. Shot clock resets. Back. Can't find room against Soriano. Soderquist. Soriano reels in the rebound. Her sixth. Kick ball. Kansas City will keep it.
Back into the eyes. Number 11, Sophia Rinoza.
Changes for the Aggies. Musa, Sule, a couple starters back in. Atkinson, in the depth of her bench in this first half, has played 10 players. Wide open in the corner, Ivory. Ring it up. Another triple for Emily Ivory, her second. Back-to-back threes by the Ruse, and they're up six. Great ball movement to get it to the wide-open shooter in the corner. Zone defense active near turnover. Henderson able to save it. Pack freeing herself, buries the long two. Gia Pack's second basket. And only her third shot attempt. Despite zone defense, the Roos have kept very close tabs on Pack so far. Two-time first-team all-league selection. Mattingly setting the screen for Johnson. Runner doesn't bank home. Musa pushing the other way. Corner Soderquist. Side the arc. They'll lob it up, but got hit on the arm. And it's two now on Mattingly. Mattingly will sit with 2:05 to go in the half. Soderquist with a pair of free throws, the first two free throws of the day for the Aggies. Soderquist, 7 points, averages 6.3 a game. Junior transfer from Odessa College, originally from Sweden. Knocks them both down, 2 point game, 2 minutes remaining, first half. Will likely play the rest of the half without Mattingly. He's the only Rue with more than one foul at this point. Johnson, nice fake. And calmly knocks down the 8-footer. And Jonay Johnson is a different player offensively this year from last year for sure, but even this point now from earlier in the season. Johnson with the deflection into the hands of Ivory. Johnson has been playing 30 plus minutes a game since becoming a starter 9 games ago. Using the ball screen. May picks up the dribble, plays in for Soriano before the shot. A foul inside. Holding foul against Buckner. Mattingly on the bench. It was a 4-point game when she sat down with that second foul. We're still up 4 at this point. Trying to get to halftime with Mattingly having 2 fouls. Ivory. Great look off the inbounds play, knocks it down. She didn't score Thursday against UTRGV. 3 threes in the first half for the sophomore. Her highest scoring game in her last 6. Prince, a floater, didn't hit rim. Johnson hurrying the other way. A Jack firing. Trickles off. Soriano battling for the rebound. Aggie ball. Shot clock is off. Bruce will put on a little backcourt pressure. Back fires it ahead, put it across the midline. Mexico State has hit just 3 out of 14 shots this quarter. 0 for 3 from 3. They bring a trap out top. Down low for Soderquist and lays it in with the left hand. Mexico State recognized it and handled it. Johnson from 35 blocked by Prince, and that's the first half. Rue's getting control though in the second quarter and extended the lead a bit with Mattingly on the bench with 2 fouls. Behind 3 threes and 9 points from Emily Ivory. Kansas City will take a 5-point lead to the locker room. J.C. Hoyt's team trying to go to 3-1 in the league. It's halftime on the Roos Sports Network.
They love. Give them Highland, healthy and wholesome, fresh from your hometown dairy.
This room represents some of the best and brightest minds in Kansas City.
And then here's my roommate.
Gotta learn how to be tough.
Your mission is to leave from this place and go out on purpose and make a better world.
Time at the Swinney Center. It's Alumni Day for Kansas City women's basketball. The alumni in attendance being introduced to the crowd here at halftime with their ruse in front of New Mexico State, 33-28. Kansas City looking for only their second win in WAC play ever against the Aggies. They're just 3-14 against New Mexico State overall. Stephen Davis with you here at the Swinney Center. Very fun first half. Kansas City got off to a great start, had an 8-0 run, went up 10-6. New Mexico State then answered with a 9-0 run to seemingly take control, but the Ruse battled back, took the lead late in the first quarter, and led most of the way second quarter, and leading it by five here at the break, although a late two by New Mexico State get the Aggies some momentum going into the locker room. First quarter, New Mexico State knocked down 4 3-pointers. Not usually their game. They hit about 4 per game. Got 4 in the first quarter, none in the second as the Ruse defense locked down. Ruse started slow from downtown, missed their first three before knocking in 5 in that first half. 3 of them from Emily Ivory and a pair from Awal Ajak. The two stars, the two preseason league players of the year, Gia Pack for New Mexico State, Erica Mattingly for Kansas City, both somewhat quiet in that first half. Pack did have 4 assists, but only 5 points. Mattingly was limited to just 1 point, spent a couple minutes on the bench after getting whacked in the head and had a wound tended to, and then sat the final 2-plus minutes of the half as well with her second foul. But it is Mattingly's Ruse with the lead at halftime, 33-28 over New Mexico State. More coming up on the Ruse Sports Network.
They love. Give them Highland, healthy and wholesome, fresh from your hometown dairy.
This room represents some of the best and brightest minds in Kansas City.
And then here's my roommate.
Gotta learn how to be tough.
Your mission is to leave from this place and go out on purpose and make a better world.
Better Minsky's. The Ruse Sports Network is brought to you by Coupini's, by Movement Mortgage, and by Mission Taco. .33-28 is the score at halftime. Kansas City with the lead, a big reason why. Emily Ivory has found her groove from distance. Three threes in the first half for the sophomore out of Davenport, Iowa. Emily Ivory had been just 1 of 13 downtown in WAC play. Ruse got her a couple looks, though, off sets. Wide open there in the corner, and then a little bit later off an inbounds play. Ivory knocking down another one off. Great execution on the screen from Christina Soriano. 9 points for Ivory, leading the Ruse. Christina Soriano setting that screen there to free Ivory, but Soriano has been the one that's been the focal point lately for the Ruse, looking for her fifth straight double-double today and on pace for it. 7 points, 6 rebounds here at the break. She has put up some gaudy numbers of late. Those 14 rebounds against Seattle were a career high. On pace for it. Double-double number 5 if she keeps things going in the second half today as the Ruse look to knock off New Mexico State. Ruse have the advantage at the break, up by 5, 33-28 over the Aggies. We've got more coming up on the Ruse Sports Network.
They love. Give them Highland, healthy and wholesome, fresh from your hometown dairy.
Represents some of the best and brightest minds in Kansas City.
And then here's my roommate.
Gotta learn how to be tough.
Your mission is to leave from this place and go out on purpose and make a better world.
Today's halftime show is brought to you by Truman Medical Centers and University Health, the official healthcare provider of Kansas City Athletics. An interesting first half. Ruse shot much better in the second quarter than the first. New Mexico State, the opposite. They were hot in the first quarter, not in the second, but the overall numbers end up about equal. As we take a look at the first half stats, 38% shooting for the Aggies, 36% for the Ruse. Aggies only had one more shot attempt than Kansas City as well. Big difference that's not shown on the screen was at the free throw line. Kansas City 8 of 10 at the stripe, while New Mexico State was just 2 of 2. Rebounds right about equal. Turnovers, Ruse are plus 3 in that category. That's big for Kansas City. With as fast as they like to play and get after it defensively, if they win that turnover battle handily, it's always a big boost. And 5 block shots already for the Ruse. They average 4.5 per game. That leads the WAC and ranks in the top 40 nationally. 5 rejections in the first half today. 3 of them by Jonae Johnson, who stands just 5'7". The other two from 6'5", Christina Soriano. Rue's up 5 at the break. More coming up on the Rue Sports Network.
They love. Give them Highland, healthy and wholesome, fresh from your hometown dairy.
This room represents some of the best and brightest minds in Kansas City.
And then here's my roommate.
Gotta learn how to be tough.
Your mission is to leave from this place and go out on purpose and make a better world.
The Rue Sports Network is brought to you by Nick and Jake's, by Cherry Sports Gear, and by Skyline E3. The second half comes your way next from Kansas City. Rue's and Aggies on the Rue Sports Network.
They love. Give them Highland, healthy and wholesome, fresh from your hometown dairy.
This room represents some of the best and brightest minds in Kansas City.
And then here's my roommate.
Gotta learn how to be tough.
Your mission is to leave from this place and go out on purpose and make a better world.
Ready for half number two. Rue's take a 5-point advantage into this second half. The New Mexico State will get possession first. They start the second half, same way they began the ball game. This is Eccles on the handle. Now Pack, who was held to just 5 points in the first half, got only three shot attempts. Also out there, Inusa, Soderquist, and shooting on the baseline and hitting is Nana Sule. Her first points, her first shot attempt. And the Aggies on the board. Start the second half. Same starting lineup for the Ruse here in half number two as began the game as well. Renee Johnson with the ball. Asia Foster Walker driving it left alley, finding Soriano underneath, blocked though by Pack. And it's off Soriano. Aggie ball. Also out there for the Ruse, Awala Jack and Erica Mattingly, who has a brand new blood-free white headband for this second half. A knock to the head from an Aggie tooth in the first half. Was bleeding from it. Pack cut off foul line, kicks it out. Eccles, nice fake. Scooping it around Soriano, missed the rim, but possession saved by Sule. Shot clock does not reset. They blow the play dead. Are they going to perhaps check and see if it hit the rim? From this angle, it appeared it did not. Look at Mattingly and her numbers today. There's a play in the first half. She got hurt, and she was in that position on the bench for several minutes. So they got it cleaned up. Shot clock does not reset. Soderquist short on the long three, but Sule saves it. Aggies can get another look at it here. Eccles spinning, kicks out. Pack will go to work. Spins into the lane and fouled. Aggies shot only two free throws in that first half. Pack to the line early here in the second, where she excels 80% at the stripe for Gia Pack. Foul was on Johnson, her second. Pack gets the bounce. Pack's three games against the Ruse last year. We mentioned the 36-point effort in the conference tournament. 18 and 12 rebounds. One of the regular season matchups, 32 in the other regular season game. Holding her to 5.5 for Kansas City is a huge step defensively against her. Johnson spinning, nice move. Soriano cleans it up on the glass and gets the roll. 9 points, 7 boards now for Soriano. And a much-needed basket for the Ruse, who hadn't scored in about 2.5 minutes, going back to the first half. Three-point game. Pack attacking in the middle of the zone. Baseline fade doesn't go. Foster Walker, an aggressive rebound. First board today for Tasia. J.C. Hoyt wanting a little more pace offensively from this team. Going to hand it to Mattingly. Missed connections. Erica back to get it. Directing traffic. Turns down the ball screen. Left hand. Rebound tipped out. Ruse have it. They get arranged. Mattingly on the wing. Trying to create. Gets a step. Gets fouled. And will shoot it two. A little hesitation after the crossover got Mattingly the half step she needed. Ruse have had good success on the offensive glass today. Christina Soriano, the main reason why. 9 offensive rebounds today for Kansas City. Soriano with 5 of those. Aggie foul was on Eccles, her third. Mattingly Just 1 point still today, 0 for 5 from the field. And 1 of 3 at the line. Very impressive what the Ruse have done today offensively without Mattingly being a big part of it. And she has just 2 assists as well. About how Kansas City has slowed back down. The Aggies have really slowed Mattingly. Ruse have been in this zone almost the entire day. Back. Offensive foul will wipe off the basket. Buckner called for clearing out. Big Aggie turnover. It's their first of the half and 10th of the game. Ruse goes small now. Ivory is in. Soriano, the only true post player on the floor. Johnson eyeing Soriano. Goes baseline. Middle opened up as Christina steps out. Johnson with a tough fadeaway. Pack clears it, brings it. Head down. Pack has it knocked away. Johnson the steal. 3-on-1 for the Ruse. Johnson all the way with the left. Coast to coast off the pickpocket, Jonae Johnson with 8 points. Lead is 6. Zone slowing the Aggies down. Wing 3 is good though for Adriana Henderson. Redshirt junior from nearby Topeka, Kansas. That's that Rue lead in half. That's the 5th three of the game for the Aggies, but the first since the opening quarter. Mattingly fakes a 3, drives it. Trying to get it to Soriano, stolen though. Soderquist the deflection. Soderquist open 3 for the tie, good. Back-to-back triples from the Aggies. Soderquist 13 points today. One shy of her career high. Johnson draws 2 on the drive. A jack trailing. The rebound. 6 straight for the Aggies. Now looking for the lead. And they've got it. Beautiful transition game. Henderson up ahead to Inusa. Timeout called by Kansas City. An 8-0 run has New Mexico State on top. Highlight for the Ruse was a Jonae Johnson steal and finish at the other end. But it's New Mexico State by 2 midway in the third.
Fresh from your hometown dairy.
This room represents some of the best and brightest minds in Kansas City.
And then here's my roommate.
Gotta learn how to be tough.
Your mission is to leave from this place and go out on purpose and make a better world.
3-1-2-3.
Some of the women's basketball alumni. It's sitting courtside at the game today. Timeout's a good time to check things on your phone. Get caught up on the action. They'll be locked into this ball game though. We'll get back to action. Mattingly handling it for the Ruse. Eight straight Aggie points. Put the Ruse in a two-point hole. Back knocking that one out. And we get a timeout. 4:40 remaining third quarter. New Mexico State 40, Kansas City 38 on the Ruse Sports Network.
Give them the dairy foods they love. Give them Highland, healthy and wholesome, fresh from your hometown dairy.
This room represents some of the best and brightest minds in Kansas City.
And then here's my roommate.
Gotta learn how to be tough.
Your mission is to leave from this place and go out on purpose and make a better world.
Here's a 3, 1, 2, 3.
Mexico State has outscored the Ruse 12-5 here in the third quarter, including eight straight to get the lead. Ruse 5 on the floor, Johnson with the ball, Emily Ivory, Erica Mattingly, Jada Mickens, and Christina Soriano. Side they go to Soriano, left block, one-on-one into the lane. Get the finish off the glass. Good solid position defense from Adenike Adarinto. Ruse stick with their zone. He's hit a couple threes in this run. Pack. The weave and the ball screen. Pull up 17 footer is short. But a rebound foul against Kansas City. And it's on Mattingly, which is her third. Decision for J.C. Hoyt. Leave Erica in. No, they'll take her out. Jack in. Pack against Johnson. And defense for the moment. Pack goes to work. Left it short. Soriano the rebound. Pack has struggled for shot attempts today. That was just her fifth. And to Soriano again. It's Adarinto, left hand this time. We're tied. Soriano double digit scoring, 11 points. Getting aligned against the zone this time. Pack has it in the corner. Attacking middle. Kick out to Prince. Step in 15 footer trickles off. Mickens runs down the rebound. Aggies have been scoreless now for over 2 minutes. He's looking to reclaim the lead. Johnson bumped and fouled by Henderson. The third quarter is brought to you by Minsky's. It's what we thought we'd have today, a tight one. Tied late third. Teams have delivered some big blows today. Big swings in this ballgame. Entry pass knocked away, and then a foul as Soriano reached in. A frustration foul. It's her second. Three team fouls each way near the end of the third. Mattingly on the bench right now for the Roos with three fouls. Dede Eccles, three fouls for the Aggies. She's on the bench as well. An Aggie turnover. Simple pass to the corner there by Pack, intended for Soderquist. And you know, Soderquist wasn't where Pack expected, or Pack just put the pass a little too far out towards the sideline. Aggies' scoreless stretch continues. Roos looking for the lead again. A jack. Not on target, but Ivory has the long rebound. Roos get another look. Johnson nowhere to go off the pick and roll. Now trying to create one-on-one. Forces it up. Over 3 minutes since New Mexico State's last points, but the Roos have gone nearly 2 minutes scoreless. Momentum hanging in the balance right now. That's a walk on Henderson. 13 Aggie turnovers for this quarter. Mattingly in there, the Roos a little trouble getting organized quickly as Ivory is short on the three ball behind the double screen. Prince baseline, hard bounce pass knocked away. Roos take it the other way. No numbers. Johnson kicks it out. Ivory, bang! Roos back in front on Emily's fourth three today. She has gotten open looks and she has kept firing. 4 of 9 now from long range. Pack to answer, no. A jack. Pack with the rebound. She was able to go 2 for 1. They should get it back for another possession. Henderson ties it with a three. Her second today. And the Aggies seventh. Now the Roos can have the final shot of the third quarter. Johnson plays to Soriano, high post left. Ivory in the corner. A little too strong, and that does it for quarter number three. 10 minutes to go in this one. Do not go anywhere. Great ball game between two of the best in the WAC. Tied at 43 in Kansas City.
They love. Give them Highland, healthy and wholesome, fresh from your hometown dairy.
This room represents some of the best and brightest minds in Kansas City.
Your mission is to leave from this place and go out on purpose and make a better world.
As we start the fourth quarter. Emily Ivory, 12 points to lead the Ruse, coming on 4 3-pointers. Christine Soriano has 11 points, 8 rebounds. Jonae Johnson, 8 points, with a career-high 4 blocks and career-high tying 3 steals. Mattingly back in for the Ruse. She sat several minutes after picking up her 3rd foul. Gets it across to Ivory, now into Soriano. 1-on-1 in the post, no double team comes. Christina has it taken away. Tried to drop off a pass, and Michaela Buckner just ripped it out of there. Aggies looking for the lead now. Pack has it knocked loose, but saves it. Soderquist, tough 3 in the corner. Hit the side of the glass. 2-on-2 the other way. Ivory gets the feet set. Missed short. Pack another rebound, her 7th. 7 points, 7 boards, 6 assists today for Pack. Buckner is fouled. Kayla Buckner looks to score when she's in the game. Foul on Foster Walker. Buckner 4 points today. And back to action this year after not playing last season. Tracks down the rebound. Eric has been very quiet today in all facets. Just her 3rd rebound. 2 points, 2 assists. Looking for one here. Ivory missed the 3 short. Ruse had a numbers advantage. Pack was still down at the other end. Unable to take advantage. And the Aggies looking to extend their lead. Noosa. Top for Henderson. Against the Ruse zone. Buckner inside. Lost it. Pack picks it up. Missed the bank shot. Big rebound. Foster Walker. Soriano running the floor. Lays it in. Excellent in transition. Getting down the court and making the catch. Mattingly found her. Just a straight rim run down the center of the court for an easy 2. Almost double dribble. Pack gets it corner. 3, Inusa. Off target. Mattingly finding Foster Walker. Now Ivory drives it left side. Floater goes, but an offensive foul is called. Wipe off the basket. Ruse scored it the last time, though. Soriano just running the floor, beating everybody down there. Every possession really critical right now. Possessions without shots could loom extremely large, as could offensive rebounds. There's a possession without a shot for the Aggies. The illegal screen against Buckner. 15 Aggie turnovers to just 10 for the Ruse.
Coming back into the Aggies, number 24,
Mattingly deep left side. 10 on the shot clock. Still plenty of time. Mattingly gets it back. Still looking for a first field goal today. Finding Soriano. Tough angle on that lay-in. Mattingly's attracting so much attention when she has the basketball. Strictly looking for teammates at the moment. Ruse leading this by one, despite Erica having just 2 points today. Wild shot by Pack. Mattingly another rebound. Mattingly's previous low scoring game this year was 6. You know, Ruse lost to the University of the Pacific back in November. Soriano missed the left-hand open lay-in after her defender fell down trying to draw a charge. Some good looks missing both ways right now. Pack tries a three this time. Foster Walker the rebound. Both teams in long scoreless stretches. Mattingly up top. Still doesn't have a field goal. .217 without points for the Ruse. Over 3 minutes for the Aggies. How is Kansas City leading with that stat line from Erica Mattingly? The rest of the team has made shots today. And the defense is locked in. There's a deflection. Almost a turnover. Firing long. Adorinto lays it in. Foul on Mattingly. Defense all got caught up. High part of the floor. Trying to force a turnover. And that's Mattingly's fourth foul. Dorinto unable to finish the three-point play. Mattingly runs down the deflected rebound. How careful does Mattingly have to play now with four fouls? Out to Ivory. Three is off. Soriano pulls in the rebound. Extra chance for the Ruse. Mattingly inside, leans in, contact, no whistle. And a technical foul now on Mattingly, and that'll be her fifth, and she's done. Must have said something to the official after the no call inside. Mattingly's battling like crazy trying to get a shot up here. There is contact against Adorinto as she spins back for the shot. Mattingly hitting the ground and then just out of frame. Technical is called. Pack will shoot the free throws. New Mexico State bench went wild after that technical call on Mattingly. They were energized. Pack hits them both. J.C. Hoyt wisely takes a timeout. Try to get her team settled down and locked back in here. Their senior leader Mattingly is done with 5:45 to go. And the Aggies up 3 on the Ruse Sports Network.
They love. Give them Highland, healthy and wholesome, fresh from your hometown dairy.
This room represents some of the best and brightest minds in Kansas City.
And then here's my roommate.
Gotta learn how to be tough.
Your mission is to leave from this place and go out on purpose and make a better world.
Three, one, two, three.
Ah! The Ruse Sports Network is brought to you by Niles Media, division of LTN, and by Truman Medical Center and University Health, the official health care of Kansas City Athletics. Aggie ball coming to the stretch run of the fourth quarter. Aggies up three. See a pack off a couple technical free throws. Kicks it over to Henderson. He penetrates. Pack now. No traveling call on Adorinto. Shuffled the feet as she caught it. And Mattingly fouled out after picking up that technical for her fifth. Ruse will have to go the rest of the way without their star. Although Mattingly today held to just 2 points on 0 of 7 shooting. Six rebounds, three assists. Arguably the poorest game of her 2 years as a Ruse. Who steps up now to lead the Ruse? Who's their creator when they need offense? Well, Ivory had nobody around the basket and didn't realize it. I thought they could have tried a layup. Foster Walker's fadeaway off target. Aggies locked down on the glass now. Aggies shooting just 1 of 6 here in the fourth quarter. They've outscored the Ruse 5-2 this period. Lorento inside. Working against Soriano. Blocked from behind by Christina. Her third block today. Ruse really struggling for offense right now. Haven't scored in more than 4 minutes. 1 of 9 shooting this quarter. 0 of 4 from downtown. Ivory uses a ball screen, goes baseline, gets bumped, and will shoot two. Christina Soriano, major factor at both ends today for Kansas City. She's in good position and gets beat. Covers for the block. Two shots for Ivory. 7 of 12 at the line this season. Perfect on the first. Emily is tied with Soriano, Ruse's leading scorer today with 13. Coming for the sophomore. Yeah, it's the bounce and roll. Ruse will set up a little three-quarter court pressure. Erica Mattingly watching from the bench. Nursing the lead. They've hit just 1 of their last 7 shots. Both teams have gone cold here in the fourth. Nichols whips it inside. Buckner had to throw it down low. Johnson with the pickoff. Another Ruse steal. They're 7th. Johnson's 4th, a career high. Janae, 8 points today. I need to look to score here down the stretch. And the game-winning basket Thursday against UTRGV. 10 to shoot at this possession. Ivory well beyond the arc to make the catch. And a hand check foul on Henderson. Cannot have both hands on an offensive player, even if nothing happens. It's Henderson's third. She's played well today. Big minutes, 25 of them to be exact. Shot clock at 10, Johnson needs help. Passes it into the freshman, Foster Walker spins. Missed the layup, Soriano keeps the rebound alive, but the Aggies get to it. Pack in a big hurry, into the lane, and a big basket for the Aggies from their leader, Gia Pack. Into double digits with 11. A three-point game with under 3 to go. Ivory near the right corner. Soriano steps out. She'll set a screen. A jack for the tie. A little bit short. Not a bad look, though. Basket here for the Aggies would be massive. And their head coach, Brooke Atkinson, feeling that as well. Takes a second timeout today. Get her team set for this possession. There's the WAC standings. That's why this one is important, even though it's still very early in the conference race. Utah Valley 3-0 already with a win over Kansas City. Bakersfield 2-0. Aggies trying to keep pace. Kansas City trying to stay right in that top group. New Mexico State hosts Utah Valley on Thursday and then Seattle Saturday. Ruse will be on the road. They're at Bakersfield on Thursday and then at Grand Canyon Saturday. Mattingly fouled out. The Ruse stick with the same lineup. Johnson, Ivory, Ajak, Foster, Walker, and Soriano. Aggies have Pack with the ball. Eccles, Buckner, Henderson, and Inusa. Inusa playing it back to Pack. Directing traffic as the shot clock hits single digits. Pack, step back three. Short. Inusa the rebound. 10-footer banks in. Huge second chance basket for the Aggies, and they are up five with under 2 minutes remaining. And the Ruse have not scored for the last 2:30. Almost a must-score possession here for Kansas City. And that clock will start to look really short. Great execution. Ivory gets a look on the wing and connects. 2-point game on Ivory's fifth three-pointer. Ruse have some momentum back. Can they get a stop? Inusa gives it to Pack. Pack wanting to attack against this zone. Can't. Inusa forced to fire. That hit the wiring above the basket. Ruse get it with a minute eight to go. Last possession. They ran a set perfectly and got Emily Ivory a look for a three ball. What does J.C. Hoyt call here? Ruse run offense in front of their third year head coach. They go to Soriano. Ivory way out, now playing into Soriano. Left hand in the lane and she'll shoot two. And that's foul number five on Michaela Buckner. Check that. Only foul number four. Apologies. Buckner thought it was her fifth. She had started for the bench. Amanda Soderquist back in for the Aggies as Christina Soriano will have two big free throws to try to tie it. Right there on the first. She's been accurate at the line today. 6 of 7 for the senior. Second shot. Too strong. Aggies have it with a 1-point lead. They can run some clock. They can get it down below 20 seconds before they have to shoot. Brooke Atkinson calls a timeout. We expect New Mexico State to use as much time as they can here. And without points, create a short possession on the other end for Kansas City. Bet the Aggies will get it in Gia Pack's hands in some form, even if it's not looking to score. She is just 3 of 12 shooting today for 11 points, but has 6 assists. Fourth quarter is brought to you by Cherry Sports Gear, the official merchandise company of Kansas City Athletics. aggressive with the Ruse get here defensively. They want to trap in the half court if the situation is right. Pack out front. Clock rolling. Ruse still in the zone. Pack. Now wants Henderson to take it. Eight to shoot. Henderson skips it. Nusa, baseline, partially blocked. Foster Walker's got it. Timeout Kansas City before the Aggies could tie it up. Or was it a foul? No, a foul against New Mexico State.
We have a foul on New Mexico State Aggies, number 32.
It's on Buckner, and that is her fifth. J.C. Hoyt was frantically trying to call a timeout from the other end of the floor when Foster Walker got the rebound. Buckner reached in to try to tie it up. So New Mexico State thought they had a jump ball. Kansas City thought they had a timeout. And instead, it was a foul against the Aggies. So Buckner is done. And Arinto will take her place. And that is also team foul number five this quarter. So it's free throws now for the Ruse. Two shots. With Tasia Foster Walker at the line. Foster Walker. 61% at the line here in her freshman season. First trip to the stripe today. Ties the game. Holmley knocking it down. Second shot for Tasia. And the Ruse lead. Now timeout called by New Mexico State. That is the Aggies' last timeout. And it will give them the opportunity to move the ball into the front court. Well, what a game today. Neither side is back down, but remember, Kansas City trailed by five with under 2 minutes to go. They have scored the last 6 points in this game. Here's what the Ruse have coming up on the road. Two games next weekend in Bakersfield and Phoenix on the WAC Digital Network before coming back here to Kansas City to take on California Baptist on the 25th. Ruse trying to win today for the second straight game. It would be only the second time this year they've won consecutive games. One defensive stop could seal it now for the Ruse. Christina Soriano, senior, calling her team together. Erica Mattingly fouled out. Technical foul on Mattingly with about 5:45 to go. They've finished this game to this point without her. Can they close it out? Pack will handle for the Aggies. Clock rolls under 15 seconds. Pack for a three for the lead. No. Soriano the rebound. Timeout, Kansas City. With 9.2 to go, Pack got a good open look, but it wouldn't drop. Tough shooting day for Pack. 3 out of 13 and 1 of 6 from distance. And Soriano with a little smile. Grabbing her 10th rebound there, giving her 5 straight double-doubles. 14 points today to go with the 10 rebounds. 14 and 11 and 6 assists in the win Thursday over UTRGV. Add one to the double-double streak for Christina Soriano. Now the Ruse need to get it in bounds. And hang on tight. Mexico State will be going for a steal or A quick foul. A wall, a Jack will be the inbounder. Would Soriano be the target here with the height and her good free throw shooting? Soriano back to the ball, they get it to her. And fouled immediately by Adorinto. Still 8 seconds to go. Soriano 6 of 8 at the line today. 75% for the season coming in. Hits the first. Ruse have scored the last 7 points in this game. Missed it. Clock rolls under 8 seconds. 2 for a tie, 3 for a win, and a traveling call on Soderquist. The Aggies' 18th turnover of the game. Timeout Ruse, their last, with 3.7 to go. Looked like New Mexico State wanted to shoot a three for the lead. They never got the opportunity. Team turnovers today by the Aggies. Ruse have turned it over only 10 times. Ruse cannot move it into the front court here, but this timeout does give J.C. Hoyt the chance to diagram what she wants on this inbounds from an unusual spot. Sideline in the backcourt is where it will be. Situation as a moment ago for Kansas City. Get it in and hang on tight. Jack will enter it. Pack will guard the inbound. In for Soriano. Ball tip, clock rolls. Johnson runs it down. Clock ticking and a foul with 0.6 remaining. They did not complete the inbounds pass, but by Soriano getting a hand on it and tipping it, the clock started. And then Johnson with the heads-up play to run it down. Now could seal it with 2 free throws. Hits the first. Jonay's 9th point today. 3 assists, 4 steals, 4 blocks for Johnson. And that should do it. For the first time since 2014, the Ruse defeat New Mexico State. A come from behind win, down 5 with under 2 minutes to go. The Ruse score the final 9 points of the game, playing down the stretch without their leader, Erica Mattingly, who fouled out on a technical foul with just under 6 minutes to go and finished the game with just 2 points. But Emily Ivory, Jonae Johnson, and Christina Soriano lead the Ruse to the win. Soriano's 5th straight double-double, 15 points, 10 rebounds. Ivory, 17 points, including 5 threes. Johnson with 10, including the clinching free throws, with under a second to go. New Mexico State was led by Amanda Soderquist with 13 points. Ruse now 3-1 in the league, 10-8 overall. Aggies are 2-1 in the WAC, 5-11 overall. New Mexico State back in action at home Thursday against Utah Valley. Kansas City's on the road Thursday at Cal State Bakersfield, both games on the WAC Digital Network. For our Niles Media Group crew led by Katie Keating, I'm Stephen Davis. Ruse win it today over New Mexico State, 56-52. Have a great rest of your Sunday. Good afternoon from Kansas City.